They have rescue teams from Florida, and they have had also help from people who've flown in from Israel and from Mexico. They work in 12-hour shifts, and they've dug a big trench 40 feet deep into the rubble, and that's been helping them to locate the people that they've found so far. There's so many issues to take into consideration, chief among them the safety of the search and rescue team members. If there's rain for quite a while, there was a fire that they couldn't locate. So much going on, on that site.
Veronica, what are you hearing in your conversations with the friends and relatives of those that remain missing or unaccounted for at this time? I mean, you must be hearing lots of very difficult stories.
Such difficult stories, ranging from the positive side of things, of course, the people who saved their lives, to the people who are still waiting to hear something. Yesterday, I interviewed a woman who came to hang a Bible verse on the fence of a tennis court that's become a memorial, and she was very emotional, and it just really has hit this whole South Florida community hard.
Well, let's talk about the community. Surfside is just north of Miami Beach. Describe the community for those who may not know it.
Yeah, it's a small, very small community. The entire population is just under 6,000, and it's about 8 blocks in length. And it's a quieter option for people originally who, didn't want to live in Miami Beach. So it had older residents and also a lot of Latin American residents as well. It has a very strong Jewish community too. You hear a lot of Russian and Spanish and English and all sorts of languages on the streets.
Well, let's talk about the investigation as it stands. The state attorney says she'll ask a grand jury to review the condo collapse and issues of building safety. Her office can review for potential criminal charges. Structural problems, right, were reported with this building back in 2018. What do we know, and what have investigators said about it?
When I've asked officials up through the evening time on Tuesday, they had told me that there are a lot of different engineers coming down to do investigations. Some of them are coming from Washington, D.C. Some of them have experiences. A firm that's coming that was tasked with investigating the 9/11 attack at the Pentagon and the bridge collapse here in Miami at Florida International University. And basically that 2018 report, while it did point out some very serious flaws in the cement, for instance, and in the pool deck, it didn't say that the building was facing imminent collapse. And we're starting to hear about corrosion in buildings nearby. We're going to start seeing across the region, across the state, people really investigating the condition of their buildings.
Well, the mayor of Bal Harbour says that village will do site visits with all 52 buildings under county recertification jurisdiction. What are surrounding jurisdictions saying about how they'll change their practices based on this tragedy?
Yes, exactly. And it is up to the cities to take initiative on this, because Miami-Dade County has required it, but that's in the unincorporated areas of Miami-Dade County. So now the cities like Bal Harbour, the village of Bal Harbour, Surfside, Miami Beach is also going to be investigating buildings. So I think the residents are going to be demanding it. And it's certainly the real estate market is going to need some kind of reassurance that these buildings are being investigated. So we'll be seeing certainly a lot of that, even up north along the coast of Florida.
You know, NPR reported that a city official had assured tower residents that the building was in, quote, very good shape. That was in 2018, despite that engineering report. Has the city or the condo association said anything about the timeline leading up to this?
At this time, they say that everything's under investigation, and they haven't really offered very clear response to what's the next step, given what the timeline that was leading up to it. And they say the investigation is going to take a while. Hopefully, we'll get more clear information coming out as investigations continue.
So what happens now in this investigation? What's the next stage in the search and rescue effort?
Well, you know, on Tuesday evening, the director of the Florida Division of Emergency Management said that they've actually asked Washington for another team of search and rescue. And it's because the state has its eye on two disturbances in the Atlantic that could complicate matters if they become an actual storm. And so they're going to have to rotate people out and rotate people in. And that's why they've asked for a little more support. And so that's going to complicate issues if, as you know, we're in hurricane season. And so that might prolong matters, but they don't step away so far from their message of hope. They've been giving examples in press conferences of people who have survived in Bangladesh, for example, a woman who survived many, many days under rubble. They do say, however, that this will take quite a while before they wrap things up.
And just finally, you've talked on social media about being part of the Miami Beach Jewish community yourself. Does this tragedy hit close to home for you?
I go there and it's like my entire childhood in front of my eyes, just in terms of like, I know what the main thoroughfare Harding looked like in the 80s. It's changed a bit since then, but you know, going to dinner with my grandfather and my grandparents at a restaurant that's no longer there, it's replaced now by Flanagan's. But it's a community that I deeply care about because that it's a Latin American Jewish community, and we have similar experiences of feeling very attached to home countries and then also kind of rebuilding lives here. And it's been really hard, to be honest. It's just, you know, being there sometimes 15 hours a day for my own choice. My editors are wonderful and wouldn't expect such a long day there, but I just have so much I'm trying to see. And there's this kind of layer of anxiety that we're all feeling, whether you're a journalist or not.